Air Combat Evolution is looking to find out if AI is currently at a state of the art where it's ready to team up with a pilot and show that these two together aren't going to hinder each other, and in fact, they're going to be greater than the sum of their parts. But before we could go on to live flight demonstrations and onto this greater world, there's this kind of open question on whether AIs could even do a dogfight, whether they could comprehend one. That's where AlphaDogfight trials came from.
The great part about AlphaDogfight trials is it's an area that we haven't really applied this technology to yet. And also it provides a great opportunity to bring the AI community together with the operational community, in this case the fighter pilot community, to help move the ball down the field.
In order to get there, we need to kind of build trust in these pilots. We need to show them that this is something that's real. This isn't just, you know, some guy sitting around in their basement kind of playing around and, oh cool, we got something that looks cool, but what's it actually doing?
APL is performing the role as the red adversary. We always need a boogeyman out there. So the red adversary essentially is providing the baseline autonomy to compete these eight separate performers.
For the first two AlphaDogfight trials, we had all these performers and all these pilots coming into one central location. You know, we all kind of stood around, we were watching the performers' results. We'd kind of, you know, go back and forth on here's what we tried, here's what's kind of working. We couldn't do that for ADT3, so we decided to take it virtual. We were worried that the engagement, if it went virtual, was going to be lower. In person, we had maybe 40, 50 people here. I think we had 10,000 people register on the first webinar. We've had somewhere in the neighborhood of 400,000 people have viewed the YouTube stream of it.
Behind the scenes, a lot of work's going on in terms of making sure that the simulation environment and the hardware and the media piece is coming together in a seamless fight. So as everyone's watching the show, we've got folks in the background that are manipulating trials runs and initial conditions and displays, doing analytics to make sure that what the audience sees is a very polished and very engaging and very technically astute show.
The world that AI is coming of age.
It's one thing to see our work as little printouts in a command console. It was another when we started seeing them as actual aircraft flying around in a 3D world. It's an entirely different experience. Once you put that helmet on, you sit down in that plane and you're like, oh, I'm actually flying. I'm trying to play this game.
This is really aggressive maneuvering. If you look at the G meters in real world, we're talking 9 Gs.
Next steps for ACE are going to be trying to take us from the simulation environment out into the real world. So that includes for live flight testing, some subscale tests along the way from there, noisy observation spaces, and trying to build pilot trust. We have to find a way for these AI agents to kind of feedback information to the pilot so he can gain trust in it, because if the pilot doesn't trust the tool, he's never going to use it.